If you are interested in taking the Part 107, or if you have started studying for the Part 107 test, you've probably realized that the FAA's original study guide is quite dense. It's 80-something pages, so I made this quick guide as I studied for my Part 107 test. It has condensed notes. So let's go through this in this video. We've got 12 chapters. You can see the titles of each chapter here. I've condensed them and simplified them a little bit, but press pause to fully read each page. This page will show you how to use this quick guide. It's simplified, it's condensed, it's more visually friendly, and it contains that critical information only. Yes, I went through the original study guide as I studied for it, underlined, annotated, etc., etc. Here is the result. Chapter 1, 6, and 12, there's really no contents within the actual study guide. It kind of refers you to these other places. So really, we're looking at chapter 2. You can see the title here talks mostly about airspace classification. That's what's going on in this chapter. And you'll want to spend some time here. This, for me, was the most difficult part. Now, as you read this, you'll want to refer back to the original if you're not sure on something. This is designed to really, this condensed note study guide is to really help reinforce some of those notions that have already been learned through the study guide itself or through YouTube videos or whatever you're using to learn this content. And so this study guide, as I mentioned, is a way to reinforce. So you can print it, you can travel with it, and it's just less dense. It's 80 pages condensed down to 18 or 19 pages or so of critical information. Chapter 3 is divided into two different chapters or subchapters talking about weather. Chapter 3A is weather sources, so lots of information about meters or METARs, however you pronounce that. And 3B is about the effects of weather. So this is definitely, there's a lot of nitty-gritty stuff in here. And kind of a cognitive exercise. You get to think about cause and effect quite a bit when it comes to pressure, density, things like that. So definitely recommend spending some time on this. And the great thing about these subtopics or these subchapters, or just the chapters in general, you can go to YouTube and type in, for example, air classification or Part 107, you know, weather effects Part 107, and you'll get professionals who can explain all of these parts in detail. So if you're having a hard time reading over the study guide, the original one, or if you're looking at these condensed notes and you're having a hard time grasping it, jump over to YouTube and use this guide as a complement to the YouTube videos that exist out there, or vice versa. At the end of this video, I will list some helpful videos for me, and certainly check the description down below. Chapter 4 is about loading. It talks about weight, stability, load factors, talking about turns, and there's plenty more here. But again, this is the condensed version. You can definitely click pause and read through this and print this version for yourself and underline, circle, you know, annotate to your heart's delight, whatever you think is important. Chapter 5 is about emergency procedures. It's very brief as a chapter. Gives you a couple of links elsewhere, but there was some information. It's not like chapters 1, 6, and 12, as we saw earlier. Chapter 7 is all about radio communication. You'll definitely want to spend some time and you'll have to go back to the original, because I'm not going to copy it, for example, the entire pilot alphabet in this condensed version. So you might have to jump back to the original for that. Chapter 8 talks about performance, kind of related to weather, as I understand it, the effect of temperature on density, the effect of humidity on density. Chapter 9 is about the physiological factors that are at play when flying a drone. Things like hyperventilation, stress, fatigue, dehydration. So this will all be on the Part 107 test. Heat stroke, drugs, alcohol, vision. We talk about scanning techniques. I mean, this study guide is chock full of details. If you've looked at some practice exam questions, it's pretty tough. So again, use as many tools as you can to help you study. Chapter 10 is about decision making. Gives a little bit of the history and then goes over terms like crew resource management, talks about risk, hazard, presents some checklists as ways to analyze risk or assess risk. So plenty of acronyms as well. And again, you can make the assumption, I think, that if you see information in here, it's what you're going to have to learn. So I recommend going through the original study guide first, as I mentioned before, and then using this document or this video to help you study once you have those basic principles already laid down. Chapter 11 is about airport operations. Latitude and longitude is a big one. Talking about antenna towers, gives some of the categories of airports. And the original study guide has some information, external links within the chapter, the introduction, and within the appendices themselves that you should be familiar with. So I've linked everything within this document and given a brief summary about each one of these things. What are these numbers and military acronym, you know, these codes? So I went through each one and made a quick notation on that for you. This is a continuation. Appendix 2 is particularly important for understanding how to register and display your registration, for example. Here's kind of a checklist. I went through a variety of documents listed within the original study guide and just made it kind of a checklist. So you can go through each one of these, and these should serve as things you should be familiar with. Make sure you know going into the test. A few videos. Now, there's a lot of videos out there. I could have listed 100, but it's better for you to get started with these three, and then perhaps you can list which other videos are helpful for you on your own. Everybody will learn differently. And then there's some places for you to write your own notes on, because you might come across, especially in the study guides or the practice test, you might come across a piece of information that I need to know that. This would be a great place to write that down. And hopefully this video has helped you. Good luck on your exam.